back, that certainly would send any athlete into the gym for a tremendous workout.
This contest, a tag team match, is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle at a total combined weight.
Oh, take a look at that, Jesse. You spot anything new in the Hart Foundation? Yeah, I see Bret Hart's got a good pair of shades on. Very observant this week, Jess. Very observant.
Of course, you know, I'm the man that brought sunglasses into wrestling, McMahon. That's what I'm most known for.
You're certainly not most known for your one-loss record. It's nice to be doing for something, I suppose. It's nice to have been able to have competed in your life and be able to talk about it, right, McMahon?
I suppose.
Other than shuffleboard or...
From the chess, that's competition.
Yeah, you were on the varsity chess team, all right.
The Hart Foundation, the hitman Bret Hart, and his tag team partner, the Anvil. Together, they are something else, especially considering they are without the services now of Jimmy Hart. They have really come into their own.
Well, I'll tell you, they're up against two tough opponents, Barry Horowitz and Iron Mike Sharpe here.
Sharpe going for the slam, and you can see sitting out on him there is the Anvil.
Oh, look at that. Up goes Iron Mike. And down goes Iron Mike.
Iron Mike back to his feet.
Rick and a baseball on that hammering away.
Iron Mike trapped the aggressor at the moment. Has the angle on the ropes now. Rips it to no. Nice reversal. Coming off the ropes. Ready for him. Back body drop. No leap part. Missing and connecting the angle.
And Mike Sharpe was smart enough to tag out because things definitely weren't going his way and they're not going Horowitz's way.
What a heave. And more of the same to Iron Mike. A kick to the midsection. Tag is made in now for the hitman, Bret Hart. Watching Sandy with Bret kick over the top rope.
Beautiful move by Bret Hart. You know, I'll say this. The Harts are wrestling very well together. They're a cohesive unit in that ring, which is extremely important in tag team wrestling.
And what aggressive tactics. Would you say that the Harts are wrestling better now than ever?
Nah, I thought they were better when they had Jimmy Hart.
Oh, come on, give up with that, would you please? As far as I'm concerned, Jimmy Hart was an albatross around the neck of the Hart Foundation.
Yeah, but they were the world champions when he had them. What are they now?
They lost the championship when Jimmy Hart managed them, is what you mean.
Speaking of the mouthless out, we had an occasion to pick up some comments from Jimmy Hart earlier on.
You know, I am finally going to let the cat out of the bag, and I know there's going to be a lot of people all over the world that are going to be so disappointed because the fabulous Rougeau brothers aren't moving to your town, but the decision has been made. The fabulous Rougeaus are moving to Memphis, Tennessee!
Whoopee. Lucky Memphis. Are you disappointed, McMahon, they didn't move in next door to you?
Yeah, I'd really like to have them in my neighborhood. Are you kidding me? Memphis, Tennessee, of all places.
I'll tell you what, they'll make Memphis forget about Elvis in a hurry.
The Hitman has been tagged in, hitting the routine. Come on. Covered by Bret Hart, the two count and the three count. Shot of luck by the Anvil, the cleaning house in there. That's one happy bunch in there as we go back and take another look, Jesse.
There's Mike Sharpe trying for a slam at the Anvil. Neidhart, then he gets picked up and caught, and the Anvil has no problem slamming Iron Mike.
Powerful man, the Anvil.
And here's Hart coming off the ropes, Bret Hart, that is, with his patented clothesline, boom, on Barry Horowitz, and the easy 1-2-3 cover, 1-2, and I guess he's showing 10 how many kids his father, Stu, had.
I don't know about that, as we take you now to the event center.